Welcome to my guide for the Lore of Shadows. In this guide, I'll go over every single spell in the lore and tell you how to best use them to make sure you're getting the most out of them in your battles. The Lore of Shadows spreads its focus across a wide range of spell types, with the main goal of hindering enemies rather than directly assisting you. The spells focus mostly on dealing damage or debuffing enemy units to make the jobs of your other units easier, with all but one of the castable spells being targeted on enemies. Overall, I'd say it's a pretty decent lore and can be worth taking if you have room and know of vastly better options. It can be used by the Beastmen, Dark Elves, Empire, High Elves, Norska, Vampire Counts, Chaos Warriors, and Wood Elves. As usual, first up we have the passive, Smoke and Mirrors. Also as usual, it's activated upon the Shadow Spellcaster casting any spell, and its effects are felt map wide. It grants all allied units plus 12% speed for 24 seconds, which is actually a pretty decent buff for a decent length of time. Unfortunately, due to the spells in the lore, you won't get many chances to utilise this speed, since the best time to cast all your spells are once troops are locked in melee, meaning only flanking units such as Cav will get to take advantage of this. Nevertheless, it's a good bonus to have, and is also free, so you can't really complain. Our first castable spell is Melkoth's Mystifying Miasma, which is a direct damage spell. It costs 5 winds of magic, has a 29 second cooldown, and a 100 meter cast range. It only affects enemies and causes them to take direct damage, and lose 24% speed for 14 seconds. It's most effective versus multiple units rather than single target, so it won't be amazing in Lord Duels, and is more suited to giving your lines just a bit of help against some units giving them trouble. It can be overcast to grant a 300 meter cast range at the cost of 8 winds of magic, and as with all spells, comes at the 50% risk of a miscast. The base spell is good for helping out the front lines, as I said before, but I can't really see any reason to use the overcast version unless you're running an army where you're trying to avoid melee at all costs, since the increase in cost is hardly worth the time you'll spend moving the caster closer to the target. I suppose if your caster is stuck in a fight but needs to support some far off units, then it could come in useful, but personally I can't see myself using it, seeing as I try and keep casters out of the fight as much as possible. Overall, it's a decent spell, but it certainly isn't going to be the bane of your enemies as much as it is a small thorn in a large side. Next up we have the Enfeebling Foe, and it's a hex spell. It costs 6 winds of magic, has a 30 second cooldown, and a 200 meter cast range. It only targets enemies, and causes them to lose 24 melee attack and defense for 22 seconds. This is a great spell for using on both enemy line holder and damage dealers, since it will ensure they power a lot less damage and let in a lot more. Overcasting grants a 44 second duration at the cost of 10 winds of magic, and should only really be reserved for the toughest enemy units or when you're dueling them with something a lot weaker that needs the extra time. While this spell is very good for shutting down key enemy units, it does require your other units to come and do the killing rather than doing it independently. This means that it requires a bit more micro to use effectively, so may not be what you're looking for if you want a quick helping hand, but if you can be bothered, then go right ahead. The Withering is next, and it's another hex. It costs 7 winds of magic, has a 43 second cooldown, and a 200 meter cast range. It only affects enemy units, and debuffs them with minus 30 armor and minus 8 leadership for 40 seconds. This makes it very useful for using against some heavily armored units that are refusing to break and die, but again, it's best used in conjunction with another unit or spell to maximise your damage. You could use it as your cav are about to charge to maximise damage, or maybe when your archers all get into range to give them the help they need to push through armour. Overcasting causes the effects to target all enemies inside a 40 meter AoE at the cost of 14 winds of magic, and is good for casting on a clump of enemies in a choke point, or for your front lines in general. This will allow you to soften up a big lump of enemies to either take out with ranged fire, or to give more than one unit on your front lines the assistance they need. Personally, the double cost can be worth if the enemy has several units that are causing you trouble, but generally, if it's only a couple of tough ones and a sea of weak ones, I'd stick to single targets just to make sure you're hitting what you want to be hitting. The effects are great no matter how you target it, and will give you a great opportunity for damage if you time it correctly and can get the micro down. The Penumbral Pendulum is next up, and it's a wind spell. It costs 13 winds of magic, has a 40 second cooldown, and a 200 meter cast range. It can only be cast on the ground, and creates a small forward moving area of massive magical damage that is devastating versus multiple units clumped up. The effect lasts for 3 seconds, and it does move quite quickly, so it can be good for targeting fast moving units if you can work out the timing correctly. The damage is very good, but you always have to remember that it also has no allegiance, so if you target it incorrectly, it's not just the enemy that can suffer. Overcasting grants increased AP damage at the cost of 18 winds of magic, and makes the spell just a little bit more effective against those supremely tough clumps the enemy might bring. I'd say the base spell is fine for anything below greatsword levels of armor, but for the minor increase in cost, you can just overcast if you feel like messing up whatever your target is even more. I personally love this spell, especially on massive unit size, since it tears units to pieces and has such a fast movement that it's nearly impossible to dodge if you time it correctly. If you really want to maximize it, then you should keep your lines flat and wait for the enemy to line up in melee and then tear their entire line to bits with a single cast. Overall, it's a great spell and worth picking up every time. Occam's Mind Razor is our second to last spell, and it's the only augment in the lore. It costs 10 Winds of Magic, has a 46 second cooldown, and a 200 meter cast range. It only affects allied units, and grants them plus 50% to weapon and AP damage, as well as imbuing magical attacks for 32 seconds. This is amazing versus both high armor and high physical resist targets, since AP and magic attacks will cut through everything like butter. While this is another spell that works best if you pick your moments and targets, if you stick it on high damage units, or units in battle with tough targets, you're almost guaranteed to get some great use out of it. Overcasting grants a 40 meter AoE at the cost of 18 Winds of Magic, and while this is crazy expensive, the ability to potentially increase your army's strength by such a large amount can make battles into a cakewalk. Dropping an overcast onto your front lines will make them mop the floor with enemies, provided your units are of a high enough caliber. Both the regular and overcast versions of this spell are absolutely worth picking up and will be invaluable to your battles once you get good at picking out key targets. Finally, we have the Pit of Shades, which is the Vortex spell of the lore. It costs 13 Winds of Magic, has a 49 second cooldown, and a 200 meter cast range. It can only be cast on the ground, and causes moderate magical damage in a huge stationary AoE. It will disrupt formations, and is strong versus multiple units of armored troops. The effect lasts for 13 seconds, so if you can box the enemy into it and they can't escape, it will easily break them before too long. This is amazing at using in a big clump of enemies, and while the damage isn't too severe, the duration can account for this if you manage to keep the enemy stuck in the effect for the full time. Overcasting increases the AP damage at the cost of 20 Winds of Magic and makes the spell that little bit more effective versus highly armored units. This does make it into an insanely expensive spell, and I'd say a bit too expensive for what it can do for you. It isn't like the Foot of Gork, where it will annihilate the unit instantly, so it's hard to justify spending so much magic on something that the enemy can fairly easily run away from. If I were you, I'd stick to using the normal version on less armored units and focus your winds elsewhere for taking on the toughest of the tough. That concludes this guide on the Lore of Shadows. If you'd like to see more videos about Total War Warhammer, then there are links in the card and in the description to my series. If you enjoyed this video at any point, then please do consider leaving it a like, as it really does help out a lot. Leave a comment of anything you think I missed or should include in future videos, and if you want to see more, maybe click that subscribe button so you stay up to date. After all, it is free. For now though, I was Colonel Dammons, and I'll see you next turn.